Hello and welcome. This is View from the Top and I am Modele Sharafa Yusuf. It is eulogized as the famous city that has two names, Eko and Lagos. The island area was originally inhabited by the Aworis subgroup of the Yoruba people in the 15th century and was later conquered by the Benin Empire, which called it Eko. Lagos, which means lakes, was a name given to the settlement by the Portuguese. The largest city in Africa and one of the fastest growing cities in the world, Lagos had a population of about 290,000 in 1950. But the United Nations estimates that its population has exceeded 20 million, and Lagos is regarded as one of the 10 most populous cities in the world. Lagos is a major financial center in Africa, and the mega city has the highest GDP in Nigeria. It has one of the highest standards of living in Africa, and has also been ranked as one of the most expensive cities in the world. Actually, there's a huge spectrum of wealth distribution among the people that reside in Lagos. It ranges from the very wealthy to the very poor. Yet, Lagos continues to attract many young people and families seeking a better life from all other parts of Nigeria and beyond. And this has also contributed to its cosmopolitan status. The king, or Oba, is the traditional and ceremonial head of Lagos, and the current Oba of Lagos, His Highness Rilwan Akiolu, is our guest on View from the Top today. We are most honored. Thank you, Kabisi, for appearing on View from the Top.
All praises be to God Almighty Allah.
Here is a quick biography of His Royal Highness before our conversation. Oba Rilwan Babatunde Akiolu was born on October 29, 1943. He got a bachelor's degree in law from the University of Lagos. Kabiyesi entered the Nigeria Police Force in 1970 and served for 32 years. He served in various capacities and became an Assistant Inspector General of Police in 1999. He was active until his retirement in 2002 and was crowned the 21st Oba of Lagos on August 9, 2003. Oba Akiolu is a member of the Nigerian Institute of Management and a commander of the Order of the Niger. Kabiyesi, Lagos has always been a cosmopolitan city where everybody is welcome. Do you think that the city has become a victim of its own success?
There is nothing like that. It is a prayer accepted by God, and God in His mercy give us more blessing. In the Quran, it is said, "Wallahu khairun razikina," that Allah is the best of all providers. And that is why Lagos is what it is today. Even those who have tried, according to them, in all what gave them, to do what they feel they should not do for Lagos, I, by the grace of God Almighty Allah, with the support of the other chiefs who later became obas, and the traditional obas, the imam, the bishops, and the good people of Lagos, told them in a plain language that we in Lagos were no-nonsense people. We will not take it now, we will not take it in future, and we will not take it at any time. But God knows we will never, never, either now or in future, use our position to take advantage of anyone. We welcome everybody. Tell me the person in Nigeria today who made name, who made things, whom God had mercy on them, who did not pass through Lagos. There is none. Lagos is a special, blessed entity. And that's why I've been advocating. And I know, during the time of this present Buhari, they will give all the special status. We deserve it.
Role of royal fathers in ensuring grassroots stability is not always clearly understood by all. Do you think it is?
Well, when you say grassroots stability, not grassroots alone. It is stability for everybody. The rich, the poor, the have, and the have none. That is why, like yesterday now, many people came from the local government. They were complaining about their sole administrator and many other policies of the government. And I made it abundantly clear to them that that is their own side. Anything they want to, they should reduce into writing. I will look into the merits and the merits of it. If they have a case to make, by the grace of God, I will take it up with the God choosing the executive governor of Lagos State. Because he had a lot of respect for me. But before I go to him for everything, I will wait. And I've not just started right from the time of Alhaji LK Jagunde. Nearly all of them has what I can call the higher respect. They knew. In my own wisdom, I don't do injustice. I don't do, well, let me say what I feel is injustice, but I do not, I repeat, I do not have reservoir of knowledge.
You know, Kamisi, so much has happened to erode the prestige of the traditional institution. Mm-hmm. How can we regain and rediscover the veneration of ancient times?
It depends on what you call regain. You see, majority of the past others, they were very, very honest and lover of their people. Some, with due respect, or monarch nowadays, they are not truthful, they are not helpful. You see, me, I believe what has gone, I don't want to refer to the past. You see, in the last administration, that incident where some monarchs assembled somewhere, and they were pointing their walking stick at the staff of office to former president. That very night, in Yoruba custom, if any monarchs did that, they are telling you are finished, go out. And they knew themselves, but because of what they have taken, they didn't want to do the truth. Whether we like or not, death will come one day. As a leader, as a traditional ruler, you have to be keeper and helper to your people. Be honest and be frank. Don't grab everything. You don't need it. Modeli, if you want to know how the world is, I always tell my friends, my wives, and they always laugh, hold 1,000. Between 12 and 12:30, when you are caught up by sleep, you meet it on the ground. And the Bible has said it, only Ashiri Nkorojo Koro Tentomano. I agree that even the Holy Prophet, he prayed against poverty. Me, I believe in hard work. As I always tell people, I'm not a rich person as many people thought, but I'm a contented person. I know how to work for money and I know how to spend money. That is the truth. But I don't take advantage of anybody. I will not take nonsense from anybody.
There's been a renewed clamor for the traditional ruler's role to be enshrined in the constitution.
Yeah, they know what they are looking for.
What difference would that make?
Traditional rulers is supposed primarily to be a customary and local government affair. They know what they are looking for. I have said it times without number. And I made it abundantly clear.
So you don't agree, Kabisi, that the traditional rulers should have a role to play in the constitution?
What if anything is wrong or you feel that it should not be so? When you are part of a system, how then can you criticize the system? The Alaafin Oyo was here some few days ago. We discussed, and he himself too agreed with me